had seen them together. They forgave she forgave him for what he did.
Oh, forgiveness.
Forgiveness. And now they're working together on the other side. They're trying to help the kids. The kids are left behind. Mm-hmm. But that's an example of forgiveness. I just wanted to, that came to mind instantly. Like, the Infinite was telling me that's the one good story, a good story to use.
Yeah.
Now, I can tell others, like, when people die, they discover the truth about people they were around because they can read your minds, you know? And, like, one of the most common things is fake friends and fake love, fake feelings that they discover people had. Like, you know, fake friends especially, you know, especially people who are think they're real popular in life, and they got all these people that know them and all this and that. But the biggest surprise is often at the moment of death, and then they look at their people and scan what they're really thinking, and they realize that they never cared about them in the first place except for using them.
Yeah,
that's what a lot of people find out. So
that gives me an idea, man. I wanted to shout out to a couple of dead spirits.
Go ahead.
I don't want to say dead, but some spirits the other side.
Go ahead.
You know who you are, Christy, Angela, Christina, there's one more. I wanted to shout out, but I'll think of it in a minute.
Just use your mind. I'm gonna see if let me shout out some spirits. We shouted out a lot of them before, but I'm gonna try to do some other one. Balewa, what's up to Balewa? You know, that's he's a good dude, man. I knew him from back in the 90s, and back in my wild days, I was in jail with him for a long time. We got to know each other in there. He died in 05, and we did a video of him coming through for his people. So if you know Balewa, that's an unusual name. So there's not many Balewas. He's from North Lakeside.
So I shout out Melinda. This girl named Melinda I grew up with. You know, based on my people that passed on and think I forgot about them. You know, there's like my, you know, I want to say hey to my grandparents, mm-hmm. you know, my aunt, my uncle, like a lot of the people that's passed on, my family. I know each and every one of you, and I've seen you, I've talked to you, I want you to know what's up. Since Melinda was a girl that I lost, you know, as a friend, you know, let's say moved on to the other side when I was very young, you know, in a car accident. And then some of the other ones I named were ones that passed on throughout the years, you know. But I just wanted to let, you know, the spirits know that I'm thinking of them too, you know.
Maybe I should say something to some of my people. I don't consider like my blood relatives and genetic family my true family. I've always been like that.
Yeah.
My true family is everyone involved in them. But not because every life it changes, we're just different genetic family. Every lifetime we live, physical life. But I do got to give credit to my grandfather, Arnold Wright, you know, because he taught me a lot. He was one of the first. When he died in 2001, I was very spiritually aware, becoming more and more aware of spirits then. And I could smell his ad. He always had the same aftershave on for decades.
Yeah.
And then after he died, right, a couple of days, I coming in working, I'd smell aftershave in the car with me.
Yeah.
And I immediately knew what it was. I was like, oh, Papa's with me. You're out on the lawn. Old Pop's in the car. And he's got my grandfather, a real open-minded, real cool dude. So, and my cousin Cameron, I think I've said this before, my cousin Cameron killed himself when he was like, I think he was 19 maybe, 2005. Yeah, he was like 18 or 19, went in the woods and hung himself, you know, because he hated his life on this planet. Tripping off of it, didn't like the world and the way his life was going. Yeah, he hung himself, and then they didn't find his body for like a year or two. It was in the woods, you know, the skeleton, basically. Yeah, I remember that, but, you know, he's all right on the other side. We thought, I'd say what's up to Cameron, to Lil, my grandfather's girlfriend.
Yeah.
You know, they're still close on the other side. And anybody else I can't think of, but Louise, my grandfather's second wife.
Yeah,
I thought about you in a while. I just wanted to say hello, too.
Yeah, they're out there, you know, they're checking in on us, I think, regularly, you know. And it's interesting, you know, just I didn't want anybody to think I forgot them. And,
same thing with me.
There's like, you know, lots of people, when they come to my mind, I'll try to shout out to them, you know. a lot of people that's passed on throughout the years, you know.
So what's up to Henry? Henry just came to mind.
Henry,
yeah, I thought about Henry in a while. Andrew and Luther's friend, Henry. Henry was murdered in 2003 so out Stockton Street, Southside, over a girl. Just a little bit of dumb argument over a female, you know. And Henry's a good dude, but Henry said one time to us that he's like, man, it was almost worth it what I went through, you know, to be in this dimension, you know, because it's so much better.
I love the girl a lot, too.
Yeah, he loved the girl a lot, as we said.
Yeah.
You know, and he's like, and he's sitting there smoking his weed. He's smoking his weed and everything, which he's doing. We see him smoking a blunt when he comes through all the time. He likes to manifest a lazy boy chair.
Yeah.
I've seen Henry come through and a lazy boy appears. He creates it with his thought. He sits on down just like this. Let's say that's a lazy boy. It's not here, and all of a sudden it's like, poof, there it is. Henry appears, poof, and he's like this. Blunt goes like pop in his hand, fires up, and he's chatting with us, smoking away. That reminds me of Andreek, too. Shout out to Drake. He was in Southside, too. Great dude, man. He died in like 2006, I think. Cool motherfucker, man.
Yeah.
Drake, you know, man, I love you, brother. You cool, man. You're a very interesting person. Anyone else you got? Let's do spirits today. We have a lot of ones we haven't said hello to.
Trying to think, you know, I mean.
It's whoever pops to mind first. Yeah. Your first impression.
Yeah, I shout out the ones that jump into my head immediately, you know.
Hey, the bishop. We got to say what's up to the bishop. He also goes by Fluff, the dude from Petersburg, man. He used to be a rapper, man.